Hi, did you know when you disobey, bad things happen? God is not happy when we disobey Him or our parents. Let's listen to the story of Noah and the Ark.
During Noah's lifetime, people were acting very wickedly. This made God unhappy. It made God sad because people seemed to be thinking more about themselves than about God. Noah, however, was a good man. Noah loved and obeyed God, and God loved Noah very much. God actually loved all the people as much as God loved Noah. But at the time, only Noah was listening to God. God told Noah to build an ark, a big boat. So Noah followed God's plan and built a boat that was 1.5 football fields long. Now that's a huge boat. Noah's neighbors laughed at him because there wasn't any water in the desert where they lived. But God told Noah that a great flood was coming. Noah tried to warn the people to change their ways so that they could hear God too. But they wouldn't listen. God asked Noah to collect two of all the creatures of the earth and bring them into the ark. He also told the animals to find Noah. So it wasn't hard for Noah to gather them together. Pairs of each kind of animal were put safely inside the ark before it began to rain. Noah's wife and his three sons and their wives were also safe on the boat. When everyone was aboard, God shut the door. Noah and his family and the animals lived in the ark for 7 days before the first raindrops fell. Then it rained for 40 days and 40 nights. Soon the earth was covered with water. After it stopped raining, the water continued to rise for 150 days. The ark landed in the mountain range of Ararat during the 7th month of the flood. God sent a big wind and the waters began to evaporate. Noah and the floating zoo had to stay in the ark for several more months while the earth slowly dried out. Finally, Noah sent a raven out of the ark's window to look for land. The raven never returned. Noah waited another week for the water level to go down and then sent a dove to do the same thing. The dove couldn't find a place to rest, so it returned to the ark. Another week passed, and then Noah sent the dove out again. This time, it came back with an olive branch. Noah now knew that the water was low enough for a tree branch to show. When Noah sent off the dove a week later, it didn't return. The dove had found a place to live on dry land. Altogether, Noah and his family and the animals lived on the ark for 1 year, 1 month, and 27 days. It was now time for all the creatures and Noah's family to move off the ark. Noah and his family and the animals needed to start life over again, and everyone left the ark. Noah prayed to God to thank God for keeping them safe. Suddenly, a bright rainbow filled the sky. This was God's promise that God would never flood the earth again.
Wow, even though the story has a great ending, a lot of people had to die. But God made a promise that if we obey Him, He will always bless us. Every time you see a rainbow, that's what it means. It means that that's a reminder of God's promise that if we obey Him, He will always bless us. So what does that mean for you? When your parents ask you to clean your room, guess what you should do? Clean your room. When your pastor asks you to maybe read a scripture or say prayer, guess what you should do? You should do it. If people who love you ask you to do things that are there to help you, you should do them. Now, if somebody tells you to do something bad, now that's okay to disobey. But when somebody tells you something that is good and something that is pleasing to God, you should do it. So, hey, that's our chant for today. I'm going to say, if I do good, you're going to say, God will bless. You got it? If I do good, and you're going to say, God will bless. Here we go. If I do good, if I do good, and that's a promise you can take for the rest of your life. If you do good, if you are obedient, God will bless you. Have a great day. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.